Hello guys, today I bring you the speedrunner builds. For your info, this build is status in all difficulties. It's good for speedrun but not for defeating bosses. I'm using Inventor in first class with White Claw. Explorer in second class with Planeswalker. Letos Emerald reduces encumbrance by 40% and stamina cost by 30%. Anastasia Inspiration, when receiving healing effects, can hash for 10 seconds. Momentum Rival, after sprint for 2 seconds, movement speed is increased by 15% and stagger level reduced by 1. Hero Heart of the Wolf increases max stamina by 25 and movement speed by 10%. Ring of Grace, taking enemy damage, causes 15% of max health to regenerate over 10 seconds. For Reclix, I'm using Enlarged Charge to double up, consume time, big fragment stamina, stamina cost, and skill cooldown. For weapons and modes, it's up to you, but I recommend Song of Ephia to slow down enemies. For armor set, I'm using medium type. Let's have a quick look for traits. Also get a tonic for extra buff. To ensure this build is tough enough, I will share the run in Apocalypse difficulty. And I will show you how to find only 2 guaranteed Fae Palace locations for foreign costs in this clip. I will not fast forward the runs for real time so we will know the speed of this build. This store will bring you to Sunken Horn, Cotton Klin, or Great Silver.
What's that smell?
When you see the boss mist door, get to the checkpoint as soon as possible. Then you can reset your build for boss.
Bleeding won't stop.
Change back to speedrunner build after the boss. follow my path to the first Fae Palace location. This door will bring you to Fae Palace locations by random. I will bring you to the second Fae Palace door from here. The second door is forward and right in Palace of the One True King. That's all for the two doors lead to Fae Palace locations at Forlorn course. If you don't get the location you want, you have to reroll the map. Next, I will show you the only possible spawning Fae doors in Marrow Palace. These doors only spawn max by 2 to fight, or you may not spawn at all in the map. So don't waste your time to find other doors after you found these two doors. Meaning, reroll. Proceed to the main objective doors until you reach Nimo area. Skip the video to Nimo area by clicking timestamp under the descriptions. Speedrun continues. This door will bring you to Sunken Horn or Cotton Klin, since there's a burning entrance. Change build for boss fight.
Still bleeding.
Change to speedrunner build. Get ready the boss fight build. He kills me for some reason, so I change to World Edge.
So it's you have just what seek I can send.
The Fae Palace doors only available after the Nimue retreat. There are 3 doors here, 1 main objective door and 2 dungeons door. Main objective door may lead you to 3 possible Fae locations: Gilded Chamber, Shattered Gallery, and Glistening Cluster. The other 2 doors are randomly spawned whether Burning Palace or Silver Location. It depends on your luck, but the Fire Palace dungeon is only available in this area. Magic door will send you to Fae Palace.
It's over.
It's hard to find pathway of the fallen in Marrow Parish Rock. Good luck. Let's find the second dungeon door to see how lucky am I. Thank you. This is the main objective though. Since we are here, let's see what's inside. Okay, it's a glistening cluster. Let's teleport to the nearest unknown location based on the map for next dungeon door. Okay, keep and stick to the right. So the final door is burning area. It should be Butcher Quarter or Derelict Lighthouse, I guess. Alright, it's Derelict Lighthouse. Thanks for watching. Good luck guys. Please subscribe for more video updates. Ha 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 ha.